Hi, in this video, I will show you how to create a DJ mix using some of my favorite dance tracks. You can use all genres of music to create a mix, but here I'm going to use dance tracks as this is my favorite type of music. In this video, I'll cover some of the new features we've introduced, such as automatic crossfading and fades, new effects from Blue Cat Audio, auto selection and grouping, locking tracks, and more. So let's start by finding and previewing some of my tracks in the media browser. When previewing, I can scroll through them. And when I'm happy, I can simply drag and drop them into the mixing window. The first thing I want to do is check the BPM, beats per minute, of my track, as currently it will play at the global tempo, which is defaulted to 120 BPM. I can view the BPM of my track in a few ways. Firstly, I can right-click on the file in the media browser and select properties. And view the BPM. Secondly, I can click on the BPM parameters icon in the track name. I would like to draw your attention to the stretching engine. For creating DJ mixes, I recommend changing the stretching engine to high quality. The reason for this is because some of your files will have a different BPM to the global tempo, and trakax will need to stretch them to assist beat matching. This requires processing power from your PC, and may put older PCs under pressure. Finally, you can view the BPM through the second properties icon on the file itself. I can view the BPM and check the BPM parameters. The segment properties icon is also very useful when you have multiple files crossfaded and you need to access the BPM parameters. So now that I've found out that my BPM of my first file is 128 BPM, I'm going to set my global tempo to 128 BPM. Okay, so now that I've decided what my first track will be and I've set my global tempo, I'll now select and drag in my second track. To start with, I will place the second track beside the first, as I want to show you a few things. Firstly, I'll check the BPM parameters in the segment properties. And I'll change the stretching engine to high quality. You're also able to expand and decrease the start and end of your file using the adjust length indicators. You'll also notice indents at the start and end of your file, indicating the start of the track and the end of the track. And if dragged on, it'll be looped. Okay, so let's start to crossfade the two tracks. To move the second track, click on it to highlight it, then hold with the left mouse button to move. When the second track is directly beside the first, you'll notice a blue arrow, which indicates it's beside the first file. Keep on moving on top of the file, and it'll begin to crossfade. You'll notice now the files are crossfaded and are beat matched. I can also click on the file to see them individually. I can also mute segments to hear them individually and to show that they are crossfaded and beat matched. So let's move on now and I'll discuss the crossfade box. You can increase and decrease the crossfade box using the adjust length indicators. If you drag the box right, you're increasing the length of track 1. And if you drag left, you're increasing the length of track 2. You can also change the fade type of the crossfade by right-clicking on the box and selecting a fade option from the fade type drop-down menu. Each fade type will change how the two tracks mix. Okay, so now I'll bring in a third track. And I'll just drop it straight onto the second track. And I'll be beat matched and crossfaded automatically. Again, I can go into the segment properties and view the BPM parameters and alter the stretching engine. When you're in the segment properties, you can also adjust the volume of the individual track. So I'll go back to my mix now and I'm going to add another track. Beat matching is not an exact science, and you may find it sometimes difficult to do automatic crossfading on the same channel. When this occurs, I usually drag the track that I want to mix and place it on the channel below. Now the track is in its own channel, and I will zoom in using the scroll wheel and manually align them myself. I can quickly set up a loop region and click on the loop play button, so only the audio within this area will play, allowing me to hear them and align them. I can also use the volume indicators to show me when the beats are matched, as the bass usually peaks at the same time. Once they are beat matched, I can remove the loop region and introduce fades at the start and end. I can simply move the cursor to the top of the start and end of the file until the fade graphic appears, and then I can drag. I can also right click on them to introduce fade types. So now I'll continue and build up my mix. So now that I've built up my mix, I would like to add effects to polish it off. To add effects, simply right click in the area where you'd like to add them, select audio effects, and choose one from the drop down menu. Here I'll select Blue Cat Audio Phaser. A blue effects grid will appear. This grid can be expanded and decreased. Change the effect levels by altering the envelopes. And access the effect properties. I can also alter the effect properties while hearing the output in real time. Again, I'll set up a loop region and manipulate the effect properties and envelopes in real time. When I'm happy, I can click Apply and OK. I can also add multiple effects into the same area. Another nice feature is I'm able to edit tracks in the track cutter. I can highlight a section to cut loops, and copy and paste them into the mixing screen. I'll press play to hear it. I can also split tracks and edit its selections by right-clicking and selecting Split Segment. Here I can alter their properties and envelopes like pitch, and I can change the pitch type. In the second part of creating a DJ mix, I'll discuss removing a track from the mix, grouping and locking segments, and saving and exporting my mix.